Greetings to all subscribers, and a very happy year of the dragon in 2024. The dragon is the only mythical creature in the 12 zodiac signs and is considered a powerful symbol of good luck in Asian culture. May the dragon year bring you all great fortune and success in achieving your dreams. As we continue, I'm excited to bring you into more detailed and clinically relevant discussions to refine your skills in diagnosis and treatment further. Basic ultrasound images and guidance for image-guided treatment will be shared with all subscribers. For those ready to tackle more complex issues, I will provide deeper insights appropriate to master and practical class members according to your advanced understanding, as these may be too intricate for general practice. Today, we will focus on normal shoulder examinations, laying the groundwork for the more complex cases we will study together. She experiences only mild shoulder pain. Upon ultrasound examination, the features appear to be within normal limits. For the initial scan, focus on the long head of the biceps tendon. The optimal position for examining the biceps tendon involves having the forearm supinated and resting on the thigh or slightly externally rotated arm. Begin by locating the long head of the biceps tendon situated between the greater and lesser tuberosities, using both transverse and longitudinal planes for a thorough examination. During the scan, assess the size of the biceps tendon and its fibrillar pattern, and look for any peritendinous fluid that may indicate pathology. For the subscapularis tendon examination, position the patient's arm in external rotation, fixing the arm against the lateral chest wall to visualize the subscapularis tendon attaching to the lesser tuberosity. Assess the tendon in its long and short axes, observing its behavior during passive external and internal rotation with the arm hanging. Slide the transducer up and down across the subscapularis to display its entire width. The tendon's width and thickness can vary due to the interdigitation of muscle and tendon fibers, hence, it is essential to scrutinize the uppermost portion of the subscapularis tendon, as minor delamination tears are commonly missed here. Such tears at the uppermost area are prevalent among golfers, arising from backswing motions and impingement between the coracoid process and the lesser tuberosity. During the scan, measure the tendon size, assess the echo texture, and check for any signs of calcification or tears from the uppermost to the lower border, scanning the full length of the subscapularis. Position the ultrasound transducer coronally over the shoulder to examine the acromioclavicular joint. Glide the transducer back and forth from anterior to posterior across the joint to evaluate for any effusion. Palpate the AC joint while scanning to correlate any tenderness with the observed pathological changes. If there is suspicion of dynamic instability, maneuvers should be conducted to assess the stability of the AC joint during the ultrasound examination. To evaluate the supraspinatus tendon, position the patient's arm so the palm rests on the superior aspect of the iliac crest, with the elbow flexed and pointing backward. When you want to find fine pathology of the far anterior supraspinatus tendon, do not internally rotate, let extension with neutral or slightly external rotation. If you want to find the fine pathology of the posterior supraspinatus tendon, let the patient's arm's internal rotation position. Begin by assessing the supraspinatus tendon along both its long and short axes. Use the intraarticular portion of the biceps tendon as a landmark to guide the proper orientation of the ultrasound transducer. The biceps tendon of the rotator interval separates the supraspinatus tendon anteriorly and borders the tendon's anterior margin. Adjust the transducer by changing the direction until you can distinguish the biceps from the far anterior tendons. It is important because young individuals have minor tendon tears, which many doctors might overlook. Sometimes, I move the humerus head to find the fine pathology of the supraspinatus and subacromial impingement with dynamic real-time images. Lastly, to assess the infraspinatus and teres minor tendons, position the ultrasound transducer on the posterior aspect of the glenohumeral joint. In contrast, the patient places their hand on the opposite shoulder. Use the junction of the posterior edge of the acromion and the scapular spine as a landmark for the infraspinatus tendon. Clinically significant infraspinatus tendon tears are relatively uncommon unless there is an associated massive supraspinatus tendon tear. In some cases, internal impingement may occur, involving the posterior labrum and the internal corner of the posterior supraspinatus or infraspinatus tendon, which can cause pain during the wind-up or arm elevation positions. Thank you for tuning in and for your valued membership. I look forward to connecting with you in our upcoming videos. Wishing you a joyful 2024, and I eagerly anticipate seeing you on my YouTube channel. Until then, take care and stay well.
새해 복 많이 받으세요. 감사합니다.